I'm here inside the polycrub, and as you can see, I have a lot of tomatoes behind me. Tomatoes, tomato, you choose. In last week's video, I shared that one of the plants had toppled over and there was a really large truss of green tomatoes that had partially snapped off. Now, I could have saved them. I could have just propped them up and let them ripen. They were still a little bit attached, but I decided that it was a sign. It was a sign for me to show you exactly how to make green tomato chutney. Now, this is the most popular recipe on my website, and it comes in really handy at the end of the growing season when you have loads of tomatoes that haven't ripened, that you don't care about ripening, that you just need to do something with, and it is absolutely delicious. Green tomato chutney is a really thick and rich condiment, and you can spoon it out of the jar and use it directly on meats and cheese, and especially a traditional plowman's lunch, really delicious. Or you can puree it up and use it as a brown sauce or a steak sauce if you're in North America. It's just an all-round delicious condiment that I'm sure will become a family favorite because it is a staple around here. And I've heard from so many people who have made my recipe that it has also become a favorite at Christmas for gifts and also with their own family. Now, as far as making it and where the flavors come from, it's very simple. You've got malt vinegar, which gives it a really deep base. There's sweet brown sugar. There's onions. There's a touch of cayenne just for a little touch of heat. And then of course you have your green tomatoes. We're gonna jump straight into making the recipe, but I do wanna let you know that the full recipe and instructions are on my website, and it's a printable recipe card. I'll put a link up on the screen so you can head over there and print it out and make this alongside the video. Preserving what you grow is so important if you want to enjoy your harvest year round, because once summer is gone, your crops are pretty minimal in comparison, but being able to preserve green tomatoes and onions and other garden harvests in jars can help you to enjoy them for the year or years to come at any point. Now, I must also say that I am an advocate for preserving the harvest, but also for using safe and modern techniques, which is why this chutney is water bathed. Now, those of you in North America will be nodding your heads yes, saying yes, this is a normal thing that we do, but people in Europe and Britain don't really water bath yet. And perhaps I'll go through that in another video, because there's a history, there's a historical reason and not a scientific reason that that is the case. But water bathing will really help to make this safe and ensure that it has a decent shelf life. And how does it do that? First of all, it helps to seal the lid. And even if your lid is perfectly sealed, if you don't water bath your preserves, you can still have microbes inside. And that's regardless of whether or not you properly sterilized all of your equipment and jars beforehand, because the time between sterilizing them and pouring your preserves in, there's air, there's all different types of opportunities for microbes to get in. And then you can have them growing inside your jar, even if it's sealed. And so there's often the case that you can open up a jar and there's mold on top. And I know that there are a lot of people who say, well, I just scrape the mold off. Well, the mold that you see growing on the surface of a preserve, a high acid preserve, it will go straight down into the preserve, even though you can't see it. It's not just there on the surface. So even if you scrape it off, it's going straight down. And mold can cause all kinds of problems. It can make you sick. It can give you respiratory issues, which is why mold in the house isn't great. And it can affect your immunity. There's just so many things that mold can do if you ingest it. So please don't eat preserves that have mold on them. So water bath your preserves, please. I don't consider this an optional step. And if you've got any questions about that, just leave me a comment down below. And if you want even more inspiration about ways that you can preserve the harvest, I have another video going through 7 ways that I preserve without pressure canning. So have a watch of that video next. Enjoy, and also enjoy making your first batch of green tomato chutney.